the moon and star. Come to me through fire and war.
Hello everyone. In this video, we'll be making an overview of Vatters and Hollows, which is an upcoming single-player arena in The Elder Scrolls Online. The arena is now available to test on the public test server and will be released with a marker DLC on November 2nd for PC and November 10th on consoles. Many players are excited about Vatters and Hollows because we haven't had a solo arena since Maelstrom Arena. But how does it compare? Let's check it out. Vatters and Hollows is located in the Reach and has a normal and veteran mode. Both modes offer a number of achievements and titles as well as ability-altering weapons. There are perfected and imperfected versions of the weapons. The normal mode awards a black die, which is supposedly the blackest black die in the game, and the veteran mode awards a skin. When you enter the arena, you meet the quest giver, which much like VMA, hands you the quest and talks about the history of the arena. The next door leads to the Choosing, which is the main hub of the arena. Unlike Maelstrom Arena, Vatters and Hollows is not composed of consecutive stages. Instead, there are three realms you have to clear before you can meet the final boss. The realms are governed by three Daedric princes. The blue realm belongs to Molag Bal, therefore inside you meet Daedra enemies and looks much like Cold Harbor. The green realm belongs to Hyrsin and contains lurches and other woodland creatures. The orange realm is governed by Marunas Dagon and has a lot of fire. You may choose to start in any of these realms with a caveat that the difficulty in subsequent realms will be higher. Therefore, if you start in the blue realm and then proceed to the orange realm, the damage in the orange realm will be higher. And when you go to the third realm, the green portal in this example, the damage will be even higher than previously. Therefore, the player is given a choice on which type of enemies they want to fight early on with lower damage and which type of enemies they want to fight later on with more damage. I have only run the arena once so far, but I will say this. If you're a vampire and leave the orange portal for last, you'll have an interesting time. Each realm has two bosses with trash mobs in between. There are also two new features. One, there are gates guarded by elite mobs, and when you clear them, they become spawn points. These are very useful because unlike VMA, when you die in Vatters and Hollows, you don't have the option to resurrect on the spot. The second feature is that there are pathways you need to traverse in order to proceed. These have enemies and environmental damage, however, they also have boosters that can help you cross the path more easily. For example, in the fire arena, you have to cross a pool of lava. In order to do that, you can heavy attack an orb that gives you a shield to protect you from the lava. Each traversing method and booster is unique and different in each of the three realms. After you kill both bosses inside a given realm, you go back to the choosing area and choose your next realm. When you beat the bosses in all three realms, the final boss arena is unlocked, which is inside that big pool in the center. When you beat the final boss, you clear the arena and complete the quest. I completed the arena in veteran mode, however, I didn't explore all the available pathways, and I'm looking forward to seeing what more it has to offer. Vatters and Hollows is visually more intricate and varied, however, I believe the mechanics leave something to be desired compared to VMA. There are also a lot of bugs currently on the PTS, so I hope they will be resolved before it's released on live. Please let me know if you found this video interesting and what are your thoughts on the new arena. Thank you for watching and see you on the next video.